Very good morning to all the children. Yes, beta, am I audible now? Fine. So I was just telling, let me clear the first point again. Ebright realized the importance of experimentation in science after losing in the science fair when he was in grade 7. So he could not win any prize because he just displayed the tissues of frog. And there was no experimentation in that. So after losing, he realized, what should I do next to win? So then he saw other winners who were into experimentation. Then he decided that definitely I will be giving my best and into experimentation, I will be putting myself and definitely win next time. So after this next point we will be covering today, it's about Ebright bagged various positions. So when you are determined, you can win, but you need to put in efforts. Without efforts, you cannot achieve anything. Fine. Ebright bagged various positions in science fair. After that, fine. 1 year he lost and he decided. Last word is fair, which I have written here. Children sitting at home, it's not visible to you. I have written science fair at last. Fine. So Ebright started preparation and every year he would show some experiment. But rather than, see, there is one quotation in English, don't do the different things, do the things differently. So Ebright thought, I'm into experimentation of butterflies. So I should show experiment of butterflies only rather than thinking about some other creature. Fine. So what he does, he took that topic only and in butterflies only he will be experimenting and he will be showing the results. And that was quite novel in his own field. Novel means new. So that newness, nobody had done that earlier. That captured the attention of the judges. and he bagged the prize when he was in next grade. Fine. So Ebright bagged various positions in science fair. Next. Next point is, he also bagged position at international level now. He also, what's your name? Name of this boy who's wearing spectacles? Vivan Uppal? Vivan Kumar. Yes, nobody is supposed to speak here. Wait. You can leave the class. Very good, Singhali. You should be very particular about your name, as if your name is being written for some prize. You know, certified. Stand up and leave the class immediately. Leave the class. Or you have other option to come here. Vivan, come here. I will not continue. Continuously, you people are looking at each other. So he also won accolades. Accolades is next word. Why I'm writing these words? So that you learn new vocabulary, but your concentration is in stupid things. That is praise better. Fine. So he also won accolades at international level. Both. So a person who's winning and being praised by others. So we say that he won accolades at international level. After participating that county science fair, you know, hunger for achievements, it increased for those who put in efforts. So efforts hi nahi karte, wo to fir wait hi nahi karenge kisi cheez. They'll keep on sitting. So he put in efforts next time. Fine. And he struck back and he won. After that, he won at international level also. And by the time when he was a teenager and then he was in early 20s, he was into experimentation only. Fine. So we will be reading mainly these points today. And one important thing, that he will be the person who is the inventor of one experiment. He will be disclosing that there were, you know, a specified gold colored spots on monarch butterfly. So there is one species of butterfly which is known as monarch, and there were some gold spots, and people thought that this is just part of their structure only. But he is the first one who will be disclosing to the world that those gold spots are actually some sort of hormone raising spots which are responsible for the growth of that butterfly. If those gold spots will not be there, butterfly will not grow. Fine. So he was the first one. So we will be reading about that also. I'm going to share the screen with you all. Clear? And rest of the students, open your books here. So we are on this page. You can see. I'm going to read from page number 35. Then in the seventh grade, he got a hint of what real science is when he entered a county science fair and lost. It was really a sad feeling to sit there and not get anything while everybody else had won something, Ebright said. His entry was slides of frog tissues, which he showed under a microscope. He realized the winners had tried to do real experimentation, not simply make a neat display. So then he realized, after losing at the science fair, first time he participated when he was in grade 7, and he lost it, but he realized something, that I should show experimentation to win, not a display only. Already the competitive spirit that drives Richard Ebright was appearing. I knew that for the next year's fair, I would have to do a real experiment, he said. The subject I knew most about was the insect work I had been doing in the past several years. So he thought, I'm into this experimenting about butterflies and tissues, and I'll be continuing with this thing only. So he wrote to Dr. Yukhart for ideas, and back came a stack of suggestions for experiments. Those kept Ibright busy all through high school and led to prize projects in county and international science fairs. So without mentor, without guru, you cannot do anything. His mentor, Dr. Yukhart, sent him ideas. Who's Dr. Yukhart? You remember when his mother bought him a book about monarchs when he was a child, and at the end of the book there was some entry, and they used to send entries and tag the wings of the butterflies. From there he got connected to that particular person. So now he responds to him and he suggested him that he can do many experimentations. Fine, two boys are about to come here now. Let me tell you who they are. So he wrote to Dr. Yukhart for ideas. He got reply, and many prize winning projects he did after that. For his eighth grade project, Ibright tried to find the cause of a viral disease that kills nearly all monarch caterpillars. Underline beta. Eighth grade mein, he started experimenting. There is a particular virus or disease which kills all the monarch butterflies. Why do these particular butterflies die? He started finding the reason behind it. I didn't get any real result, he said, but I went ahead and showed that I had tried the experiment. This time I won. So he could not find the reason that why those butterflies die, but his experimentation could make him win at the science fair. The next year, his science fair project was testing the theory that viceroy butterflies, but I dhyan se suna, a bit complicated. There are typical different species of butterflies. One is viceroy butterflies, other is monarch butterflies. So in this next year project, usne apna level aur complicate kar diya. What was that? I'll be asking you, any of you, those who are talking, that what was his project in class 8? What was that in class 8? Yes, Tanya. Fine, sit down. So now in eighth grade, viceroy butterflies, they look like monarch butterflies. You know, they are very similar. When you see them, you are not able to make differentiation that which one is viceroy butterfly and which one is monarch. So his experiment was on the topic that viceroys look like monarchs because monarchs don't taste good to birds. So monarch butterflies, when birds eat butterflies, you know that life cycle when one creature eats the other. So the theory was based on that viceroys, they look like of monarch, and monarch, they do not taste good to birds. Birds do not like to eat monarch butterflies. So viceroys, on the other hand, they are very tasty for birds. Clear? Dikhne mein same hai, but birds do not prefer monarch butterflies because their taste is different. But they prefer viceroy butterflies. So more they look like monarchs, the less likely they are to become a bird's dinner or victim. So birds ko kya galti lagegi? Birds will think that they are going to eat a monarch butterfly. It does not taste good. So the viceroy butterflies will be able to save their life. Got my point? That was his point. Itna deep mein, nobody can think even. So Richard Ibright was doing experimentation on this thing. Clear? So Ibright's project was to see whether, underline this line, in fact, birds would eat monarchs. He found that a starling would not eat ordinary bird food. It would eat all the monarchs it could get. Ibright said later, research by other people showed that viceroys probably do copy the monarch. This project was placed first in the zoology division. What is the pronunciation of whenever ology word is there, you pronounce it differently, okay? It's not biology. Most of you say biology. It's biology. Bi is different, that other part is different, fine? In that way, zoology, fine? So this project was placed first in the zoology division and third overall in the county science fair. Underline. So this project of viceroy and monarch butterflies bagged him various positions. You have seen that Discovery Channel once or a while. So minute observations are required. Actually, every act of these creatures, they are recorded on camera. Fine. So after experimentation, after recording, thesis banta hai, theories likhi jati hai, and then conclusion. Fine. So this is a long process. So that he was into, you remember his mother bought him a camera and a telescope, and in that way he was using it and observing the behavior of the creature. So he might have observed, observation is recorded in the project, and then experimentation is done, and then conclusion is formed. Kisi bhi theory mein aap dekhoge. So in that way, last paragraph says that Albright's project was to see whether birds would eat monarchs or not. So he wanted to see whether birds will eat monarchs, because monarchs do not taste good and viceroy, they do taste good. So he wanted to check it out. So he found that a starling would not eat ordinary bird food. It could eat all the monarchs it could get. Fine. But due to that look-alike feature, some birds were eating monarchs also. Clear? Due to this, because they look like viceroy. So their species will also get to the end of extinction. Kaise koi species khatam ho jati hai? Because one particular creature is eating the other. So this is a cycle. So his experimentation is on that only, that whether these particular butterflies will be eaten up or not. So it varies. Clear? So the overall idea, you can keep it in mind. So we are on page number 36 now. Yes, children, is it clear? Jaldi se bataiye, is it clear to all of you? Fine. So we are on next page. In his second year in high school, Richard E. Bright began the research that led to the discovery of an unknown insect hormone. That point I had not written, but I discussed with you. Fine, that gold sports wala. Indirectly, it also led to his new theory on the life of cells. The question he tried to answer was simple. Underline. What is the purpose of the 12 tiny gold spots on a monarch pupa? Pupa is the beginning stage of becoming a butterfly. You remember that stage? Aapko bhi yaad rakhni hai, pupa, caterpillar, whatever. Clear? So, next theory is, what is the purpose of 12 tiny gold spots on a monarch pupa? Abhi abhi monarch puri proper butterfly nahi bani hoti hai, but it starts generating spots on it. And other scientists were thinking this is part of their beauty only, that they are like this. But he will be the one to discover that these gold spots are going to produce some hormone which will lead to growth of these butterflies. Clear? Tabhi wo pehle stage pe hi aa jate hain spots, because they have a reason. Next is, everyone assumed the spots were just ornamental. Ornamental means decoration. Albright said, but Dr. Yukart did not believe it. Dr. Yukart, because he was having the knowledge of butterflies, he also believed in the same thing. To find the answer, Albright and another excellent science student first had to build a device that showed that the spots were producing a hormone necessary for the butterfly's full development. Who generated this idea? Dr. Yukart. This was not the idea of Albright. Idea was given by his teacher, his mentor, you can say, but it was experimented by Albright. Clear? So along with other excellent science students, they started working upon this idea. They generated, they made one device. That device could show that this gold spots are producing a hormone which leads to full development of the butterfly. This project won Albright first place in the county fair and entry into the International Science and Engineering Fair. this project changed his life. He got first position in county fair at local level, and then this was the base of entry at international level also. There he won third place for zoology. He also got a chance to work during the summer at the entomology laboratory of the Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. Because he got third position at international level, तो जो बच्चे top three थे उनको मौका मिला to work with higher level scientists and higher level research center. That added more into his curiosity, more into his knowledge, and he continued his journey and never looked back from that time onwards. Fine. As a high school junior, Richard Ebright continued his advanced experiments on the monarch pupa. That year, his project won first place. See the step. Success does not, it is not elevator. There is one quotation again. Let me discuss with all of you. There is no elevator to success. I always say, elevator is lift, jo directly aapko upar le jaati. These days, we people are so reluctant of walking the stairs. Let's take the elevator, directly we will reach our destination. There is no elevator to success. You have to take the stairs. So step by step, one should reach one's goal. Sabhi aapke success ka fayda hai. The success which is attained by short cut, it will remain with you for short span of time. But if you have put in efforts for years, you have lived through the difficulties, you will be getting success throughout your life or better part of your life. Clear? So this is what Ebright had done. Ebright has won many prizes. पहले वो फेल हुआ बच्चा, he did not stop, he participated, he got third prize at science fair, then first prize, then again first prize, then won entry into international fair, फिर international fair में third आया, and then finally, you know, he kept on learning through his mistakes, and finally he got first prize at international level. I'm speaking, you can, this is again Chahad, again always don't create negativity only. पॉजिटिव सोच रखिए कि हो सकता है. आई टेल यू वे सी लुक एट मी यू आर सेइंग ऐसा कैसे याद रखेंगे. याद क्या रखना है आपको, दैट ही पार्टिसिपेटेड एट काउंटी साइंस फेयर. ठीक है, व्हाट वाज द काउंटी साइंस फेयर एट स्कूल लेवल. व्हाट वाज हिज प्रोजेक्ट, टिश्यूज ऑफ फ्रॉग्स. उसने डिस्प्ले लगाया सामने एंड ही शोइंग टू पीपल, बट अदर स्टूडेंट्स वर शोइंग एक्सपेरिमेंट्स एंड ही लॉस्ट इट. इसमें क्या याद रखना है. Fine, he lost the first experimentation, but that gives him efforts that I will be putting in next time. So next time he showed experimentation of monarch butterfly only. So Tanya gave right answer to this. Fine, and then after winning third prize, bas third to first yaad rakhna. He bagged third position, and then next time again first position in county science fair and entry into international fair at the same. Jab bachcha first aata hai at national level, then entry milti hai international level. When he bagged first position at county science fair, he bagged entry into the international fair. When he got entry into the international fair, he got third prize again, and third ke baad again he bagged first. Third, first, third, first. Paanch cheeze maine boli hain. Firstly, he lost. Third in county science fair, first in county science fair. Third in international fair, first in inter. It's very easy to remember. This is a very easy order. And the thing is, you need to remember the name of the projects only. And he is doing experimentation on monarch butterflies only, nothing else. First was frog tissues. Rest all butterflies. When it seems to be difficult, I understand from a student's point of view. But when you try to understand, when you break it into chains, it is very easy. Clear? Those who are listening, they will understand. Jo beech mein sunte hain, beech mein baatein kar rahe hain, they won't be able to make it. Next is, as a high school junior, Richard Ebright continued his advanced experiments. He did not stop there. Usi cheez ko leke is moving forward. So now he is going to experiment on monarch pupa. That year his project won first place. Fear gave him another chance to work in the army laboratory during the summer. In his senior year, he went a step further. Kya wo step tha? He grew cells from a monarch's wing in a culture and showed that the cells would divide and develop into normal butterfly wing scales only if they were fed the hormone from the gold spores. I'm just telling you, next level of experimentation was he knew how to generate cells of butterflies. Cells usne differently generate kiye. Then he used those spores on those cells of butterfly and it turned into a real butterfly. That was the next level of experimentation. Clear hua aapko? That project won first place for zoology at international fair. Clear? And then he got participation at next level of agriculture. The following summer, after his freshman year at Harvard University, Albright went back to the laboratory of Department of Agriculture and did not more work on the hormone from the gold spores. Using the laboratory's sophisticated instruments, he was able to identify the hormone's chemical structure. So you need not remember this. So he was digging more details into the hormone of the butterfly. Chemical structure mein aa gaya. A year and a half year later, during his junior year, Albright got the idea. We'll be finishing this page only. Albright got the idea for his new theory about cell life. It came while he was looking at X-ray photos of the chemical structure. Next, uska concentration tha, bas itna aapko keyword yaad rakhna hai. Chemical structure of a butterfly. Fine. When he saw those photos, he did not shout Eureka. Eureka means, the meaning is given at the back of your book, a cry of triumph at a discovery. Even after discovering, he did not shout. Or even I have got it. Usne itna bhi nahi bola, I have got it. After this big experiment, he believed that along with his findings about insect hormones, the photos gave him the answer to one of the biology's puzzles, how the cell can read the blueprint of its DNA. Okay, beta, bell has gone.